Just gonna be doing a Q&A / freshman advice targeted to like LSU students, of course, but freshman advice goes both ways, so I'm pretty sure whatever university you've decided to go to, this advice can also help you. So a little about me, my name is Hannah, I'm 19 years old, born and raised in Houston, Texas. I'm a freshman at LSU, class of 23, majoring in general business with a minor in psychology. So I have about 8 questions and concerns. If there is a question or something that I did not cover after watching this video, just go on ahead and drop a comment below. Hopefully after watching this video, it's given you a little bit more clarity on what you decide to do, whether if it's coming to LSU or not. Hopefully just these advice and these tips come in handy to you, as I wish they would have come in handy to me when I was in your place. So my first question is why I chose LSU. I chose LSU primarily because of the distance from home. So me being from Texas, it was easy to get like there and back on the weekends, but it was still far away from home, so that way I still like felt far enough from my parents, you know, like I didn't want to feel close to home. I don't think really anyone does when they go to like when they go off to college. I was that kid that was like, take me to the farthest place, the furthest away from home, but it's still like I needed to come home sometimes for, you know, emergencies like this, being in a pandemic. Yeah, one of my main reasons was just like the distance was like almost perfect. And then when I went to visit LSU last year, it was just like a crazy experience. It really wasn't even all that crazy. It was just when I stepped on the campus, I felt like the energy, and I loved it, and I was like, I could like be here. Like, it was one of those like movie college experience things. I like when you go visit a college, you get those feelings of like comfort, like you know you love it there and like you know you're gonna love it there. So that's what I felt when I went to LSU. The third reason would be because of the business school. The business school is just completely beautiful, and I can't wait to actually experience it more, seeing all of the different benefits. And then lastly, LSU has such a strong like community. Like, LSU take care of, like, they take care of LSU. It just opens up a lot of opportunities in the job world. I just knew that being there would start establishing a lot of connections and you start networking. So my second question, advice on housing. So here's my advice on housing. Definitely look into getting a residential dorm. Don't do traditional. Like, traditional absolutely was the worst decision I made going into LSU. And no, I'm not being dramatic at all. It was literally like we had to get out of there. I pushed residential so much because it's just a lot of benefits, and really the dorm is nicer and you still get to have the opportunity to room with whoever you want. Like, you can pull them in through the housing portal. It's definitely allowed. Even if they're from a different major, you can still do it. That whatever your major is, choose residential. The dorms are way nicer. I don't know of one residential dorm that's just not nice. So I know that all of the residential dorms are en-suite bathrooms except for one, and that was Broussard Hall. That's the dorm that I ended up switching to in the middle of the semester. Whole different story. Long story short, I was in a traditional dorm called Herget, and it was just so bad. Me and my roommate, we just had to move, and the only available space that they had for the both of us was in Broussard. Yeah, that was the only dorm that had community bathrooms. It's really old too, so it, you know, I don't even know what they're gonna do with that. As far as the other dorms on campus, they are, the residential dorms are just beautiful. You dorm with people in your major, so getting help when you have tests and homework assignments, it's easy. You know, you just go down to one of the study rooms, And 9 times out of 10, there's going to be someone down there studying for the same thing as you. So it really comes in handy. And you have tutors down there all week long, I believe. I think it's, if not all week long, then Monday through Thursday. But I know they were down there like all the time. And so you can get tutoring in your dorm sooner or later. I don't know about your first semester, but I know during the second semester it really kicked in. You start taking classes in your dorm. So you would have a class right downstairs. All you would have to do is roll out of the bed and walk downstairs. I really missed out on the convenience of it all, and I wish I could take it back. Now, if you've already done your housing and you've chosen traditional, don't worry. I mean, I was just kind of picky when it came to like where I was gonna be living. Not all of the traditional dorms are like that, but I know the best one is Cedar. It's super new, brand new. En-suite bathrooms, big rooms, it's really spacious. Yeah, and it's super hard to get into. So if you got into it already, congrats to you. That's probably like the most exclusive dorm on campus. And then you have like the bottom of the barrel for traditional out of the whole campus is Herget and the Pentagon. Those two, from what I've been able to see and experience, are the worst dorms on campus. A lot of people end up switching next semester. So if you have a dorm that you're not happy with and you're not comfortable there and you're like, you hate it, you know, just email the Res Life and they're gonna give you a specific window that you can request to be switched out. And 99.99% of the time, they will switch you out within like the next few days. So don't worry about that if you feel like you've made the wrong decision. The west side of campus is literally like the lit side of campus. The west side is the best side, and that's where you wanna live. Like, we stayed on the east side first semester, and we were on the west side, like taking the transit every night to the west side every night. That's like where everybody is, really. Like, that's where all the social life really happens. Like, so much happens. Everyone's experience is different, but it's always fun. A lot of the residential halls are on the west side of campus already. Cypress, Spruce, Broussard, the Pentagon, South, North, and West Hall. I know for a fact all of those are on the west side of campus, really close together, and those are closer to your classes also. The student union is pretty centrally located, but the west side is closer to like more of your classes in the quad and like off-campus restaurants. So it's way more convenient to live on the west side also. My third question is, how's the food? The food is honestly as good as it can be, you know, when it comes to dining hall food. It's not nasty, but it has its days. And there are just some days where you're like, nothing here is like it. I remember one day, I think I had a waffle for breakfast, lunch, and dinner because it just wasn't it. Some days, like, that's like your only option. But there are two dining halls, the 5 and the 459. They're both on the east and west side of campus, like literally smack dead within the dorm. So it's not a far walk from your dorm, wherever you're living. It doesn't matter. Depending on your meal plan, I had 12 swipes and like 600 paw points. And so if you gotta save those paw points because you only get them for the semester, make sure you take advantage of the dining halls. They say that the 459, which is on the east side of campus, is better than the 5, which is on the west side of campus. But personally, I've never tasted a difference. And in the middle of the semester, the kitchen staff, they switch anyways. So you'll be able to get a taste of both. What I can say is the pizza at the 5 is better than the pizza at the 459, and the 459 has better ice cream than the 5. So it's like stuff like that. One is gonna have something better than the other. On days that you don't want to go to the dining hall, you can use your paw points at any of the on-campus food restaurants. We have food trucks, which are usually parked outside of Patrick F. Taylor, the engineering building. There's a Panera Bread, Subway, 2 Smoothie Kings, McDonald's, Chick-fil-A, 2 Coffee Calls. The list really goes on. There's a Starbucks. Like, there's so many on-campus restaurants to choose from. I think we have like the widest variety. That really covers the food on campus. It's good to me, you know, and you get used to it the more you're there. It's okay. So my next topic is advice on scheduling your classes. The most important thing, like, if you don't take any advice from this video, just do not schedule your classes before 10:30. Do not schedule the 8 a.m. Don't schedule the 9 a.m. And I wouldn't even go to 10 o'clock because you're still gonna have to wake up at least 9:30 to make it there on time, like depending on where your dorm is. If you're going to be on the east side of campus and then your class is on the gym auditorium, just know that you're going to have to be leaving your dorm at 9:30 a.m. to make it to that 10 a.m. Yeah, LSU, even though we are a strong academic school, we also party on the weekdays. So if you catch yourself at a party on the weekday, which you might, we all say we don't, but it's going to happen. It happens to all of us, you know, your freshman year. If you're at Tigerland on a Wednesday or a Thursday and you have a class the next day and you scheduled at 8 a.m., 9 times out of 10, you're not going to make it to that 8 a.m. And then who knows what you might have to do. You might have a pop quiz or a test, and, like, you know, you're not going to be attentive at all because you're going to be tired. So it's just safer, and it's always best to schedule classes more, like, afternoon, early afternoon, like as early as you can go in the afternoon. It just saves time in, like, your mornings study. And yeah, depending on what you have going on in the evening, like I took an evening class and it really wasn't even all that bad. Your professor most likely lets you out early. I know that during my evening class he let us out an hour before class, like almost every class. So evening classes really aren't that bad, but stay away from the morning classes. I wouldn't do it. Nobody does. We always regret it. You're going to end up changing the time when the ad drop period comes around. You're going to end up trying to get into all the later classes, and they're going to be full. Like, if you really are a morning person, though, go for it. But it's going to change. Like, it's not like high school where you have somebody forcing you to get up. Everything is 100% a choice, and so you're going to choose, and you're going to make the choice not to wake up one morning when you realize that you have to get up at like 7:30 a.m. It's so not gonna happen. Another helpful tip with scheduling your classes is going on ratemyprofessor.com, or I think it's also an app too, just to see, you know, who your professor, who your options are. A lot of professors offer extra credit at the end of the semester, and they also do a lot of curves. So checking to see if your professor is one of those is important. In the summertime, when y'all get to scheduling your classes, make sure you have like the app downloaded so you can go ahead and make sure you're choosing the right professor, because it's gonna be a lot of professors who don't care if you have a 69, 79, 89, they won't give you that 1 point. But there are some professors who will give you like 8 points. So it's good to make sure you have one of those. Another helpful tip is don't take on too much that you can't handle, but it does come in handy to add a few extra hours just in case that you have to drop a class when they start allowing you to drop classes at the end of the semester. So, but make sure you have enough so that way you can still remain as a full-time student status. First semester, I didn't have enough on my schedule, but I had to drop a class, and it dropped me down to a part-time student, which didn't affect me because I'm not on a scholarship, but if you are on a scholarship, it can affect you. As far as knowing what to schedule, getting with your advisor is really helpful. I was always in my advisor's office at the UCFY. You can email them. I'm gonna drop all of the important email addresses for the university just to make it more convenient below in the description, so you can check that out after the video. Emailing your advisors or going to the UCFY on campus, they'll let you know during the first week, you know, what you can drop and what you should add. When you do your scheduling during your orientation, you're gonna have your degree audit there, and it has like literally a list of everything that you should be taking. It's really easy. It's not rocket science. So my next question is, what are my favorite places on campus? So my first favorite place on campus is the rec, because it's big and it's beautiful, and all you need is your Tiger card to get in. There's a Smoothie King, an indoor pool, an outdoor pool that spells out LSU with a lazy river. You can take group X classes. There's a wide variety of classes like that you can take, and you can rent canoes too and take them out to Campus Lake and like go canoeing. I've never done that, but I wanted to. The rec is located on the east side of campus, so when I was living at Hergate, it was literally 5 steps out the door. That was probably the only perk of living at Hergate, was having the rec so close to me. My second favorite place on campus is the Quad. One reason is because they shot scenes there on Pitch Perfect. If y'all didn't know, Pitch Perfect was shot at LSU. So if you watch the movie, like being at LSU and then you watch the movie again, you're gonna see like a lot of spots. So yeah, the Quad is my favorite spot. It's really like the most socially active spot on campus. Like, it's just a great spot for everything. You see people, you meet people. Like, those first weeks of classes, first and second semester, the quad is gonna be the spot because everybody's going to class the first week, so everybody's there. And my third favorite place on campus is the business complex. The business complex is just gorgeous. It's so nice. It's a great quiet place to study. My next concern is about hair, nails, haircuts. Okay, as far as hair, nails, haircuts, it's very student based, I would say. So it's tons of people on campus who do those things who are like really good. My nail tech stayed on campus. Lash techs stay on campus. A lot of guys that do haircuts stay on campus too. It also helps to like look up hashtag LSU Lash Tech, hashtag LSU Nail Tech, like hashtag BR Lash Tech, hashtag LSU Barbers, like all of those things can lead you to more people. And don't go to Supercuts in the Union. So my next question is on football, tailgates, and the club scenes. On game days, you walk out of your dorm and it's like the whole campus is dripped in purple and gold. It's so many people. Tents are like everywhere. Like, I really miss it. I miss it a lot. I never actually went to a tailgate, but on the west side of campus in the Enchanted Forest, there was an Alpha tailgate and it was just so much fun. You know, for homecoming, there was another tailgate, like a really big one, and it was, again, like fun. So those are the only two tailgates I've actually like been to, but there's so many. Football games, they allow a student pack for tickets. I heard a lot of people did it during their orientation, and they send out an email. It's basically just a student pack of tickets for the entire semester that you pay for, and it gets you into all the home games at Tiger Stadium. You're gonna want to do that because I didn't do that, and I like had to buy a ticket before every game, and it's way more expensive to do that. But Tiger Stadium is awesome. Death Valley is always lit. Like, it's always so much fun at football games. Yeah, nobody does it like us when it comes to football. As far as like parties and clubs, there's not like many like house parties. I know that Tigerland is usually lit, but we only go if it was like a major event happening, so like on game days. It's basically just like a street with a whole bunch of different bars, and they do have a strict dress code for boys though, that like is a forever long list. Like, no earrings, chains must be tucked. I don't even think you can wear no joggers. It's like a lot of like different rules and dress codes for Tigerland, so not like, we don't really like fade there a lot. Go to the District. Dead Poet was the scene once. It's not no more, unfortunately. City Bar and the Palace. Those are some fun clubs that we go to on the weekends. Usually at the lodges is where they have like little house parties. Those are always so fun. Like, the best party that you will ever go to will probably be at the lodges. So my last question is, what is my favorite memory being at LSU? Let me stop playing. I don't actually think I have one favorite memory being at LSU. Like, even though my freshman year was cut short, it was the best experience of my life. I wouldn't trade it for the world, and it was honestly the best to me. I can't complain. I met so many great, awesome people who I know is gonna be in my life forever. I've witnessed so many things. I've got to experience so many things. Like, I got to experience a whole national championship in New Orleans. That was so much fun. Like, top five memories for life. Yeah, LSU is just a great school. I just know I'm gonna have way more memories. Like, if you're going, I'm excited for you, and you should also be excited. If you're not going, you should definitely apply. Just kidding, not really. But yeah, it's a great school, it's a fun school. But as far as my favorite memory, I'm just gonna include a little compilation of videos of my favorite memories at the end of this video. So with that being said, that concludes this video. If you want a part two, let me know in the comment section. Questions or other advice, concerns, comments that you have for me. And if I get enough, I'll make a part two. Make sure you like, comment, subscribe. I'm gonna be doing more videos on this channel. Be on the lookout for makeup tutorials, beauty vlogs, get ready with me vlogs. I have a fashion haul coming up, So turn on my post notifications, subscribe, and I'll be back with a new video. Of course, go Tigers. Bye.
This is the beat, y'all, of the year.
Yo, man, it's a lot of brothers out there flaking and perpetrating, but scared to kick reality. Get the gas, 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 get the g